16. Of course, that's a big release on PlayStation 4. They were really high on that one. They also, on this show, which is something I'm a really big fan of, apart from criticizing this show, they also interview a lot of celebrities about video game reviews, their favorite video games, and celebrities who've had a hand in doing voiceover work, especially for video games in the past, like Norman Knoll, of course, who was the voice of the Penguin in the Arkham City Batman titles on PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360 from back in the day, or Charles Martinet, of course, who we all know and remember and love as the voice of Mario from all the original Mario titles, which go back as far as the original Marios on the original video game consoles and video games like N64's Mario 64, which I was a really big fan of. So every once in a while, you'll see a celebrity review and a celebrity interview and appearance on that show. So that's one of the things that I'm really high on about gaming show from my parents' garage. When I first heard of the title of the TV series, Gaming Show from My Parents' Garage, which is very difficult to roll off the tip of your tongue. The thing is about this, I was kind of skeptical on it. I was really skeptical, filled with skepticism on this, because I said, you know, what in the name of God is this? A TV series that is reviewing video games possibly from your parents' garage? Now, obviously, it doesn't review video games from your parents' garage. It's just an authentic title to jump out at you. But that's one of the things that I started to wonder about and became very skeptical on. You know, how is this show going to get over? And because Disney has never really attempted doing a video game review show before in their past, because I can't remember them ever trying to attempt something like this, where are they going to be able to get it over on a network like Disney XD, which is not really that great of a network, in my opinion? I've come down really hard on Disney XD over the years because I was never really a big fan since its premiere of Disney XD. If you wanted to have an extreme Disney channel, you could have done something a lot better, far more impressive than what you did with the premiere of Disney XD. I appreciate what Disney are trying to do, reach out to an entirely different audience than what are used to seeing things on Disney Channel from previous years, especially in the U.S. and the United Kingdom. But the thing is, if you wanted to have a Disney XD series, a Disney XD channel, of course, with extreme Disney programming, you could have just taken your original Disney shows like Wizards of Waverly Place and Hannah Montana and kind of mixed them up a little bit and made them more extreme in the way of a presentation than what you did on the original Disney channel. Like, for instance, you could have more marathons, you could have more airings of your favorite Disney channel shows that you don't get to see all the time on the original Disney channel. You could have done so much more with it, so I wasn't really a big fan of Disney XD. I can't ever remember really putting over Disney XD for anything it's done in the past, but this is one of the few times I'll make an exception for Disney XD and choose to put something over that's actually worth talking about on the network. It is one of the best Disney XD original series that I have seen in a long time. They also go above and beyond the requirements of a standard video game reviewing TV series that you wouldn't expect them to do, because we see a lot of great review video game shows over the years, but this one is definitely one that really reaches an entirely different global audience. And of course, they also expand their video game reviews on their Facebook page and on their Twitter as well to give you more of an in-depth look at things like that. Also, they have an official website too with a lot of video game reviews and an overflow of content, which I really appreciate. It's very updated. It's got easy organization and navigation, which is something that's on the plus side when you talk about reviewing a website. Also, they have key pointers and downloadable content on things like their Facebook page and Twitter as well, like expansion packs, links to download for your video game experiences to really pick up on those. And it's just so cool how interactive this show is. You can also submit your own content to the show, too, for them to share on an upcoming episode that probably is in production of Gaming Show from My Parents' Garage, which is something I really appreciate from Disney, because not enough interactivity, I find, comes from Disney. You never get a chance to have a live chat with a celebrity from a Disney Channel show. You never get a chance to have a meet and greet with any of them that you may be experiencing on Disney Channel, one of your favorite Disney Channel shows, for instance. So the interactivity of this show is really there. So there is something from this show for every member of your entire family to take from. And I think it reaches out to a lot of different age demographics, but primarily I think the age demographic this one is trying to reach out from, as I previously mentioned, could be anywhere from the age range of 6 to 15 years of age, depending on what a fan of a video game you are. You could be a sports video game fan, you could be a role-playing video game fan, but again, you know, there's something, there's a different theme for every episode of Gaming Show from My Parents' Garage, and depending on whatever video game you're a fan of, role-playing through sports, there's something in this series for everybody. And I also really appreciate the overflow of enthusiasm from the cast that we see on this series. I have never seen them before and in previous Disney XD or Disney Channel shows in the past, so they are all coming together for the first time, making their premiere on Disney XD, and hopefully they'll have promising futures with Disney Channel shows or Disney XD projects coming up in the future. That's something I would like to foreshadow for the cast of Gaming Show from My Parents' Garage, because they do such a fantastic job. Now, initially, Before posting this video on my YouTube channel at JonathanClark22, I thought I was going to come on here and fill up this video along with the majority of my thoughts being critical comments towards the cast of a gaming show from my parents' garage or some of the things they review from time to time on their individual episodes, like Ratchet & Clank, the Batman Arkham series video game, of course. I thought I was going to fill up this video along with the majority of criticism and critical comments towards it, but, you know, it's coming off pretty decent, pretty gentle with my review this week on gaming show from my parents' garage, because as I look down through my notes, the majority of thoughts that I've compiled for gaming show with my parents' garage didn't come off as critical as what I initially thought they were going to, and it's a pretty easy ride through the beginning of this show right through to the end, so I don't want to apologize for saying that I was going to come down hard on them last week here on the show when I was promoting that I was going to be talking about gaming show from my parents' garage, because initially what I thought I was going to do was I was going to come off really hard and be a son of a bitch and review this show and probably give it a 1.5 star rating out of 5 and a 5 star scale potential rating that I could have given a gaming show from my parents' garage, but I'm not going to do that because the interactivity is really there, and there really is something for every member of your entire family to come away enjoying from this series, and there's something really worth talking about finally on Disney XD. Disney XD may have struck gold with this series because, as I mentioned, you know, I've never seen anything like this produced by Disney before in their previous years. They've been working with Disney Channel shows and, of course, Disney XD, the spinoff of the original Disney Channel, and, of course, Disney Junior. I really appreciate what they're doing here, and I hope they keep this series heading into at least 2018, because this is a show that you can get a lot of years out of. You can get a lot of seasons out of this, and you can easily get 10 years out of the three members of the cast that make up gaming show with my parents' garage, definitely ensuring them profitable futures with Disney, without a doubt. I wasn't really a big fan of this series when it first premiered because I really didn't know that much about it. I didn't make a consistent or religious habit of watching the show, but once I started watching individual episodes of gaming show from my parents' garage from time to time, I kind of take a reprieve, kind of take a step back and take a break from watching the show. But when I would watch series shows from time to time of this one and get really in-depth with the detail of the show, I quickly became a fan of gaming show with my parents' garage, so hopefully I'll get away without criticizing this show and come off this show getting a good impression given to Disney XD for the job they have done with this series, because it's one of the best Disney XD shows I have seen since the channel's premiere, which I can't remember back as far as when they actually premiered, but ever since they premiered, this has got to be the best show they have got. And when you talk about animated shows, probably Gravity Falls or something like the 7D have it with animation. So when you're talking about live action, it's definitely gaming show with my parents' garage right there. Either that or something like Aaron Stone, and something for animation could be the 7D or Gravity Falls. You know, I always thought that a show like Dog with a Blog, focusing on the talking dog Stan, who writes his own blog on the computer, probably belonged on Disney XD, as I did a lot of Disney Channel shows that probably didn't get a chance to be on Disney XD. I always thought shows like Dog with a Blog, probably even Wizards of Waverly Place, belonged on Disney XD. But for the shows that we have on Disney XD's lineup now in late 2015, heading into 2016, possibly 2017, things are looking more probable in the way of a direction and a future for Disney XD, which is something they didn't seem to have. And gaming show of my parents' garage could be the torch carrier, the proverbial torch carrier for Disney XD series in the future, heading into years like 2018 over the next three-year period. But I'm going to leave it up to you guys, and you can give me your reaction and your initial thoughts on gaming show from my parents' garage. If you like the show, if you dislike the show, there are things you like about the show or things you don't like about the show, you can give it to me in the comments of this video blog at JonathanClark22 as we wrap up our near three-week review of video games, Jonathan Clark Reviews, on this channel at JonathanClark22. And, of course, on Twitter, you can tweet me your opinion at JonathanClark1 and on Facebook at EGW Entertainment. And don't forget Google Plus. I can't forget that. At EGW Entertainment, you can give me your thoughts and initial reactions you guys came away from gaming show with my parents' garage from, and let me know what you think of it. I think it has a promising future, and it's probably one of the best and better Disney XD series that I've seen in a long time, but I'm going to leave it up to you because your opinion is what this show from week to week comes down to. And again, guys, thank you for joining us over the last three-week period talking about things like WWE 2K16, Ratchet & Clank 2016 in the spring of next year, and of course, gaming show from my parents' garage, which is wrapping up our three-week review of video games and Jonathan Clark Reviews on this YouTube channel. Thank you guys so much. By the way, I've subscribed to their Facebook page, Gaming Show from My Parents' Garage, and I am following them on Twitter for you because I am really impressed with what they're doing with their video game reviews on things like Wii U, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One. It's very updated, and it's a gaming show for the future generations of video gamers that are up and coming from anywhere from 6 to 15 years of age, and there is something in this show for every member of your entire family to take away from it. I'm your host, Jonathan Clark. Thank you guys again so much for joining me over the last 3 weeks for Video Game Reviews and Jonathan Clark Reviews on this YouTube channel. If you like any or all of our content, you can subscribe to our channel at JonathanClark22. You can follow me on Twitter at JonathanClark1, and you can subscribe to my Facebook page at HEW Entertainment, where you'll find the Facebook fan page for things like Gaming Show from My Parents' Garage, and of course the Twitter at JonathanClark1 is at JonathanClark1, where you can find the Gaming Show from My Parents' Garage Twitter account for updates on video games. Tell me what you like about the show, what you don't like about the show. Let me know what's up in your mind, and I will see you next week.
You're listening to HEW Entertainment Radio, home of radio show host and columnist Jonathan Clark.
You can be amazing, you can turn a phrase into a weapon or a drug. You can be the outcast, or be the backlash of somebody's lack of love. Or you can start speaking up. Nothing's gonna hurt you the way the words do when they settle near your skin. Kept on the inside and no sunlight, sometimes a shadow wins. But I wonder what would happen if you